बोलिए श्री आर शक्ति जगदंबिका माता की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। आर शक्ति जगदंबिका माता की जय, सब संतन की जय, सब भक्तन की जय। जय जय सीताराम, जय जय राधेश्याम, नमः पार्वती पतये, हर हर महादेव। शंभो। श्रद्धा निष्ठा भक्ताः सर्वेषां कृते सुस्वागतं व्याहरामि। अस्मिन् महोत्सवे विराजमानाः श्रद्धा निष्ठा भक्त उन सभी भी मैं सुस्वागतं करता हूँ। इट इज माय प्रिविलेज वंस अगेन टू एक्सटेंड अ कर्टियस वेलकम टू ईच एंड एवरीवन as we celebrate our annual Navaratri festival. We are honored to be blessed to have the facility of this wonderful venue, the Constantine Park, Mokoyat, Tunapuna, for celebrating this annual festival of the Divine Bhagavati. Each night our festival receives coverage with Sankhya Television. So please tune in, enjoy. We are pleased to welcome each and everyone once again. And as we do each night, in our commencement, we offer our devotion and our gratitude to all those who, having combined their passion, their mutual passion for this remarkable achievement and incredible success, we say thank you. Let us celebrate the feminine divine as we read the scriptural reading called Saptashati Path, as we offer ourselves through katha, through kirtan and through japam. As we withdraw our thoughts, focus your minds upon her resplendent form. May Bhagavati enter into the pores of our being. As Surya Narayana, light rays illuminated her entire being, every pore, through darshan we are receiving those energies each night during this chosen cyclic period of the Navaratri, a period where Bhagavati has been worshipped for thousands and thousands of years. The return of this season and the return of the epic through scriptural reading all reminds us of the historical battles that were fought. Those historical battles that were fought predates humanity's recorded history, but it is there, written by the sages and the seers, for us to remember a time when the gods walked upon this earth, a time when the devas and the asuras fought great wars for the purpose of preservation of the universe for the purpose and preservation of dharma and the purpose and preservation of humankind. Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om Sri Sarasvatyai Namaha. Om Sri Guru Charana Kamalabhyo Namaha. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwarah, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Akhanda Mandalakaram Vyaptam Yena Characharam Tatpadam Darshitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Sthavaram Jangamam Vyaptam Yena Krishnam Characharam Tatpadam Darshitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Chidrupena Paritvyaptam Trailokyam Sacharacharam Tatpadam Darshitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Dhyanamulam Gurur Murti Puja Mulam Gurur Padam Mantra Mulam Gurur Vakyam Moksha Mulam Gurur Kripa. Om Bhadram Karnebhih Srunuyama Devaha Bhadram Pashemakshabhijajatrastirairangai Stushtuvagumsastanubhirbhyashe Mahidevahitam Jadayuhu. Om Swastena Indro Bridhastravaha Swastana Pukha Vishwavedaha Swastanasta Yaksho Arishtanaimi Swastino Brihaspatir Dadhatu. Om Shanno Mitraha Sham Varunaha Shanno Bhavatvaryama Shanna Indro Brihaspatihi Shanno Vishnu Rurukramaha. Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Vritam Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Tanamamavatu Tarabhaktaramavatu Avatu Ma Avatu Vaktaram. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Vyasaya Vishnu Rupaya Vyasa Rupaya Vishnave Namo Vai Brahmanidhaye Vasishthaya Namo Namaha. नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये जय जय मैयालक्ष्मी जय गजवदन गणेश जय जय माता शारदे जय जय भारत दे। We offer up our hearts and our beings in loving gratitude to Guru Maharaj, the many gurus and the many guru parampara, the traditions of the rishis, the sages, the saints and the swamis, those who have carried the torch for humanity's enlightenment. May we glorify Guru Maharaj.
गुरु मेरा पार ब्रह्मा भगवंता गुरु मेरे पूजा गुरु गोविंदा गुरु मेरा पार ब्रह्म गुरु भगवंता गुरु मेरे पूजा गुरु गोविंदा गुरु मेरा पार ब्रह्म गुरु भगवंता गुरु मेरे पूजा गुरु गोविंदा गुरु मेरा पार ब्रह्म गुरु भगवंता गुरु मेरे पूजा
जयति ओम अस्य श्री नवारण मंत्रस्य ब्रह्म विष्णु रुद्रा ऋषयः गायत्रुष्टिक अनुष्टुप छंदांसि श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वत्यो देवता ऐं बीजं ह्रीं शक्तिः क्लीं कीलकं श्री महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती प्रीत्यर्थे जपे विनियोगः ब्रह्म विष्णु रुद्र ऋषिभ्यो नमः शिरसे गायत्रुष्णिक अनुश्चुप छंदोभ्यो नमः मुखे महाकाली महालक्ष्मी महासरस्वती देवताभ्यो नमः हृदि ऐं बीजाय नमः गुह्ये ह्रीं शक्तये नमः पादयोः क्लीं कीलाय नमः नाभौ ॐ ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विद्महे ॐ ऐं अङ्गुष्ठाभ्यां नमः ॐ ह्रीं तर्जनीभ्यां नमः ॐ क्लीं मध्यमाभ्यां नमः ॐ चामुण्डायै अनामिकाभ्यां नमः ॐ बीचे कनिष्ठिकाभ्यां नमः ॐ ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे करतलकरपृष्ठाभ्यां नमः ॐ ऐं हृदयाय नमः ॐ ह्रीं शिरसे स्वाहा ॐ क्लीं शिखायै वशट ॐ चामुण्डायै कवचाय हुम् ॐ बिच्चे नेत्रत्रयायै वौषट ॐ ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै बिच्चे अस्त्राय फट ॐ ऐं नमः शिखायाम् ओम ह्रीम नमः दक्षिण नेत्रे, ओम क्लीम नमः वाम नेत्रे, ओम चाम नमः दक्षिण कर्णे, ओम मुम नमः वाम कर्णे, ओम डाम नमः दक्षिण नासापुटे, ओम यैं नमः वामनासापुटे, ओम विम नमः मुखे, ओम चेम नमः गुह्ये, ओम ऐं प्राचय नमः, ओम ऐं अग्नेयै नमः, ओम ह्रीं दक्षिणायै नमः, ओम ह्रीं नैऋत्यै नमः, ओम क्लीं प्रतीच्यै नमः, ओम क्लीं वायव्यै नमः, ओम चामुण्डायै उदीच्यै नमः, ओम चामुण्डायै ऐशान्यै नमः, ओम ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे ऊर्ध्वायै नमः, ओम ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे भौम्यै नमः। ध्यानम् खंगं चक्रकदेशु चापभरिछान् शूलंभुशुण्डिं शिरः शंकं संधदतिं करैस्त्रिनयनां सर्वांगभूषावृतां नीलाश्मद्युतिमास्य पाददशकां सेवे महाकालिकां यामस्तौ स्वपिते हरौ कमलजो हन्तुं मधुं कैठभम्। ॐ ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे ॐ ग्लौं हुं क्लीं जुं सः ज्वालय ज्वालय ज्वल ज्वल प्रज्वल प्रज्वल। ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे ज्वल हं सं लं क्षं फट् स्वाहा। As we fill our hearts with the ecstasy of divine love to the feet of Bhagavati in Kirtan, we glorify Bhagavan Maryada Purushottam Shri Ram, who having fulfilled the requirements of the Navaratri devotion to Bhagavati was able to vanquish the wicked ruler Ravana.
हरे राम 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 सीता राम राम राम, हरे राम 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 सीता राम राम राम, हरे राम 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 सीता राम राम राम। राम 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 सीता राम 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 हरे राम 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 सीता राम 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 हरे राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता 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 राम 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 हरे राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता राम 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 सीता राम 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 हरे राम 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 सीता राम 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 हरे राम 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 सीता 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 राम राम
This chapter, which completes the battle narrative, began previously. The underlying theme of the first half is the ease by which Durga Ma and her lion counter the strenuous efforts of Mahishasura's generals, whom they defeated one by one. This allegory tells us that the dharma which the Devi upholds is the natural state of existence, and that the asuras, the negative impulses arising from the ego, are in a sense going against the current. These asuras, they are internal as well as external. Bhagavati destroys all the external elements that brought destruction. But inwardly, through our prayer, mantra, japam, kirtan, scriptural reading, called patha, she destroys all the internal enemies. Durga is said to be as immune to attack as Mount Meru, a mountain made of gold and gems that stand at the center of the world. Durga's Maya demonstrates that Chiksura was destroyed. He showered arrows and missiles upon her, but he posed no threat to her than a gentle rain falling on the summit of the holy Mount Meru mountain. Mahishasura's other mighty generals meet their destruction. Like those previously defeated, those also have names that describe their repulsiveness. Karal, gaping mouth. Udhat, arrogant and rude. Tamra, oppressive. Andhak, morally blind. Ugrasya, fierce. Ugravirya, brutally strong. Durdhanda, bearing evil. Durmukha, abusive, foul mouthed. These are the internal aspects of the external asura. Durga's defining moment, her defeat of Mahishasura, is described here as a wrathful beast with formidable power. Not even the gentle clouds are immune to his harmful, damaging, destructive fury. Whom? Mahishasura. Such fury is a pure negative expression. Expression of Rajo Guna. Of the three gunas, Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, and Tamo Guna, the fury of Mahishasura is an expression of negative Rajo Guna. To meet its challenge, the Devi heightens her own Rajas, her own Rajogun. But while Mahisha's rage controls him, the Devi's Rajogun is completely under her control. We are controlled by our Rajogun. We are not in control of that guna. Therefore, one loses the battle whenever Rajogun takes over. But if Rajogun is controlled and is directed in a righteous manner, then it is righteous Rajogun. Consider human anger individually and collectively. Depending on the choices we make, it manifests either as destructive rage or as righteous provocation that counters evil. In other words, destructive rage is Mahishasura, and righteous provocation that counters evil is described as Chandika, the one who, having Rajogun under her control. In other words, when provoked by what is perceived as unfair, evil or imbalance, the Devi's reaction to this is the same rajogun, but righteous rajogun as opposed to Mahishasur's instinctive beastly rajogun. In the combat, Mahishasur undergoes a series of metamorphosis, and as long as he continues to mutate from buffalo to lion, to man to elephant, and back to buffalo, Durga cannot slay him. While this play goes on, her weapons appear ineffective. Each time she delivers what should be a fatal blow, Mahisha eludes destruction by changing his form. The buffalo demon Mahishasur becomes intoxicated by his own mind. His might, no doubt, bolstered by his evasive ability, and in response, Durga drinks a potion that reddens her eyes and her face with intention to slay him. The final real battle begins. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Hara, 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 Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Hara, 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 Mahadev. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Hara, 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 Mahadev. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Har, 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 Mahadev. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Shiva, Shiva, Shambho, Bholenath Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Har, 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 Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Vishwanath Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Vishwanath Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Bholenath Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Shiva, Shiva, Shambho, Ganga Dhari Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Ganga Dhari Shambho. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Bholenath Shambho. Celebrate.
शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो जटाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो
Rishi says, seeing total devastation of the demonic forces, Chiksur, their commander, seething with fury, advanced to fight with Ambika. Sadevim Sharavarshena Babarsha Samare Sura तथा मेरु गिरे श्रृंगम तोय वर्षे न तोयर He rained missiles at भगवती अंबिका as a cloud showers rain on the summit of Mount Meru. She promptly cut apart his bow and their high-flying banner. His bow having been destroyed, she pierced his limbs with her swift missiles. With broken bow, without a chariot, his horse and charioteer slain the Asura, armed with sword and a shield, rushed towards Ambika Bhagavati. With his sharp-edged sword, he struck the lion on his head and struck with great force the left arm of Devi. As soon as his sword touched the arm of Devi, it was shattered into pieces. His eyes, red, shot with rage, he then picked up his lance and flung it at Bhadrakali, the gentle Kali. It dazzled his lance, dazzled like the orb of the sun falling from the heavens. Hate tasmin mahavire mahishasya chamupatau Hate tasmin mahavire Mahishasya Chamupatau. The mighty general of Mahisha was slain. Chamar, the tormentor of the Devas, came riding on an elephant. Chamar, one of his generals. Evam Sankshiyamane Tu ससैने महिषासुर महिषेण स्वरूपेण त्रासयामास तान गुणान् When महिषासुर saw his forces being disseminated, he assumed the form of a buffalo and started terrorizing the forces of the Devi. After defeating the forces of the Devi, he charged to slay her lion. Then the mother became angry. Mahishasur, great in valor, equally angry, started striking the earth with his hoof. Lifting the peaks of the mountains with his horn, they were flung skywards as he bellowed frightfully. Under his frenzied wheeling, the trampled earth broke apart. Lashed by his tail, the ocean overflowed all around. Crushed by his horns, the clouds fragmented and dispersed. Tossed on his blazing breath, mountains by the hundreds fell from the sky. When she saw the great Asura approaching, inflated with rage, Chandika arose with wrath and prepared to slay him. Sa chiptva tasya vaipasha tamba bandha mahasuram tatyaja mahisham rupam sopi baddho maha mridhe. She threw her noose over him and bound him. Fettered thus in the fierce battle, the great Asura left his buffalo form. Tata singho bhavat sadyo yavat tisyam vikashira chinnati tavat purushah khangapanira trishyata. The great shape-shifter Mahishasur assumed the shape of a lion. No sooner had Ambika severed his head than he appeared as a man with sword in his hand. Instantly, with her arrows, the Devi cut him to shreds along with his sword and shield. Then he took the form of a giant elephant. Karena cha mahasingham tam cha karsha jagarja cha karshayastu karam devi khangena nirakrantata, and dragged her mighty lion along with his trunk. But while he trumpeted aloud, the Devi chopped off his trunk with her sword. Tato mahasuro bhuyo mahisham vapurastitaha. Once more, the great Asura assumed his buffalo form and caused the three worlds with all that is moving and unmoving to tremble. Tatah krodha jaganmata chandika puramuttamam papau punaha punaschaiva jahasarunyalochana. Angered, Chandika, the mother of the worlds, drank a divine potion, and with eyes reddened, she laughed again and again. She laughed the laugh of death. Devyuvacha गर्ज गर्ज क्षणम मूढ़ा मधु यावत् पिबाम्यहम् मया त्वयि हते त्रैव गर्जयिष्यन्त्याशु देवताः. द देवी सेड गर्ज गर्ज क्षणम मूढ़ा बेलो बेलो योर फूल बेलो नाउ व्हाइल आई ड्रिंक दिस पोशन यावत् पिबाम्यहम् मया त्वयि हते अत्रैव आफ्टर आई हैव स्लेन यू गर्जयिष्यन्त्याशु देवताः. द गॉड्स विल चेयर इन दिस वेरी प्लेस. ऋषिरुवाच एव मुक्त्या समुत्पत्य सारुढ़ां तं महासुरं पादेनाक्रम्य कंठे च शूलेनैन मताडयत्. द ऋषि सेज हैविंग डिक्लेयर्ड दैट तुम महिषासुर विद रेडन्ड आईज शी लेप्ट अपॉन द ग्रेट असुरा pinned his neck down with her foot and pierced him through with her spear. Tatah sopi padakrantas taya nijabukhatata adhanishkranta evasi devya pirena sambritah. Trapped under the feet of Bhagavati and crushed by her might, he merged halfway in his true form from his buffalo mount. He merged in this way from the buffalo's mouth. Ardha nishkranta evasau yudhyamano mahasuraha तया महासिना देव्या शिरश्चित्या निपातितः. Half revealed and fighting still, that great asura fell to the devi, beheaded by her great sword. ततो हाहा कृतं सर्वं दैत्यं सैन्यं ननाशतत् पहर्षं च परम् जगमुहु सकला देवता गणाः. ततो हाहा कृतम् देन क्राइंग आउट इन अलार्म द होल डीमन आर्मी पेरिश्ड एंड ऑल द डिवाइन होस्ट एक्सल्टेड टुगेदर विद द ग्रेट हेवनली सीयर्स. द देवस प्रेज्ड द देवी. The celestial musician sang and throngs of nymphs began to dance. Shiva Kailaso ke Vasi, having offered their prayer, their suppliant prayer, Dhauli Dharo ke Raja, Shankar Sankata Harana, that Lord who is both Bhagavati, Ardhana Ishwar, half Shiva, half Shakti, the Devas, sang in praise of Bhagavati, in praise of that Supreme, who has no birth, who has no beginning nor end. अंत बेअंत तेरी माया नो वन कैन मेजर ऑफ फादम हर ग्रैंडियर. एज दे ऑफर्ड इन रिजॉइस एज दे रिजॉइस द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ महिषासुर लेट अस आल्सो rejoice together.
शिव कैलासों के वासे धौली धारों के राजा शंकर संकट हरना शंकर संकट हरना शिव कैलासों के वासे धौली धारों के राजा शंकर संकट हरना ओ भोले बाबा शंकर संकट हरना शिव कैलासों के वासे धौली धारों के राजा शंकर संकट हरना ओ भोले बाबा शंकर संकट हरना तेरे कैलासों का अंतान पाया तेरे कैलासों का अंतान पाया अंत पे अंत तेरी माया ओ भोले बाबा अंत पे अंत तेरी माया शंकर संकट ओ भोले बाबा शंकर संकट हरना बेल की पतिया भांग धतूरा बेल की पतिया भांग धतूरा शिव जी की मन बोलू भाये ओ भोले बाबा शिव जी की मन बोलू भाये शंकर संकट शिव कैलासों के वासी धौली धारों के राजा शंकर
in this way. Bhagavati destroyed Mahishasur along with his army and friends, slayed, deluding the three worlds. After the fall of Mahishasur, all the beings of the three worlds, Bhu, Bhuva and Sva, including the Devas, the Daityas, Danavas, the demons and humans, the three categories of beings, subhuman, with demonical nature, they are called Asura. The Devas, they all rejoice chanting the victory, Jai Mata Di, Jai Mata Di, Jai, Jai Mata Di. Ya Sri Swayam Sukritinam Bhavaneshwa Lakshmi Papatmanam Kritiyam Hridayeshu Buddhi Sraddha Satam Kulajana Prabhavasya Lajja Tam Tvam Natasma Paripalaya Devi Vishwam. We bow before you, you, the personification of wealth and fortune, Yasri Swayam Sukurtinam Bhavanesha Lakshmi. You are the giver of wealth and fortune in the homes of the virtuous. Papatmanam Kritidhiyam Hridayesha Buddhi, who brings adversity and calamities in the home of the sinners. Sraddha Satam Kulachana Prabhavasya Lajja. Intelligence in the minds of the wise you give. Sraddha Tam Tvam Natasma Paripalaya Devi Vishwan. You give reverence, you give faith, you build faith and reverence in saintly persons and modesty in noble people. Please, O Bhagavati, protect this universe. Devi Prasida Parama Bhavati Bhavaya Sadyo Vinashayase Kopavati Kulani Vigyata Betat Dhu Adhunaivat Yadaswametan Nitam Balam Subivipulam Mahishasurasya. Devi Prasita Parama Bhavati Bhavaya. O Devi, you are supreme. Be gracious to all your creation. For when angered, you can annihilate multitudes. We saw this the moment you brought Mahishasur's vast power to an end. The army of Mahishasur has been annihilated by you in a matter of minutes. Thus, worship by all the devas with praises, celestial flowers of the Nandan garden, the celestial divine heavenly garden was showered upon her, perfumes and heavenly incense. The mother of serene countenance spoke to them, whose heads were bowed down in obeisance and loving devotion. Debhyo vacha kriyatam tridasha sarve yadasmatto bhivanchitam. Bhagavati says, tell me, O devas, ask whatever you wish of me, please with your praises, I will happily grant it. Deva ucho. The devas replied, the gods said, the Supreme Bhagavati has done everything. Nothing remains now that our enemy Mahishasura has been slain. Even then, O Supreme Sovereign Bhagavati, Chandika, Mahishasura Mardini, if a gift is to be granted by you to us, then please deliver us from great misfortune. And when there is any, every time we remember you. Moreover, O Mother of clear countenance, any mortal who with these praises, mantras, who praises you, may those mortals be blessed with ever increasing wealth, prosperity, power, family, and other fortune. This was the request of the devas on behalf of humankind. The universe being threatened by total annihilation of the demonic forces, trillion, billion, million, thousands in number, has never ever happened in the history of any creation. That Mother, the Creator, as Brahmani, as Kamalani, she sustains, and as Rudrani, she preserves, and Rudrani, she reabsorbs. Here, that Bhagavati is prayed to by the devas. Protect all humankind, wherever they may be, when they shall offer these praises to you, as we have been doing. And may they be blessed with prosperity, power, ever increasing wealth, family, and other fortunes. This is the universal dharma, universality of Sanatan Dharma, which breaks every boundary. It addresses humanity's predicament, which is universal. It goes beyond every limitation, class, creed, religion, dharma, race, beliefs. It has nothing to do with these limited outlook of today's humanity. It presents universality. It presents itself in a universal manner. Thus, Bhagavati blessed the devas, and their request was granted that moreover, not only the devas, but during the Navratri period of her festival, those who will perform scriptural reading called Patha, those who will sing and glorify, those who will do mantra japam, aim, hrim, klim, chamundayai vichye, those who will occupy their time in listening and in reciting, their hearts will be filled with the ecstasy of purity, the ecstasy of love and purity for the divine. That compassionate mother's love will enter. Your instinctive nature will be destroyed, as there are so many foes in the outer world. Likewise, there are equal and more enemies within. These enemies are described. These enemies are described in this manner. As Durga Maiya triumphs over Mahisha, only when he is forced to reveal his true form, her act of pinning down his neck under foot is a potent metaphor, because to pin down means to find out, to ascertain, or to determine. Until the true cause is pinned down, we remain subject to unsettling influences. Our mental states may mirror King Suratha's and merchant Samadhi's confusion and their despair of Mahishasura's overwhelming rage. The symbology of the slaying casts more light on the process of spiritual awakening. Durga's piercing of Mahisha's side with her spear represents the penetrating light of understanding. It forces the demon to emerge in his real form. It identifies six passions which are universal to human experience: uncontrolled desire, anger, greed, pride, jealousy, and delusion, along with other forms of ignorance such as fear, prejudice, hatred, like Mahishasura and his attendant demons. They present themselves in an interacting array, and they are all exceedingly difficult to deal with until recognized for what they really are. Desire is, in the broadest sense, any kind of longing for sensory gratification, material wealth, or power. Inherent in it is a sense of deficiency, limitation, or separation. Any desire is ultimately the desire for wholeness, and when prevented, it may turn into krodha, anger. When gratified, it may become inflamed into lobha, greed. Greed is impossible to satisfy. It is excessive and insatiable. Because the ego by its very nature remains deficient, no amount of gratification can fill its void. Additionally, fixation on the ego will manifest as pride, a sense of superiority that in turn can induce feelings of jealousy. Jealousy in turn creates apprehensive resentment of the prestige, positions, or good fortune of others. These are the internal demons, the internal asuras, the internal daityas that we must face day to day. But these are also personified as real characters in day to day life. But they have all been destroyed. by Ma Chandika. They've all been destroyed. Now, through listening and recollecting these episodes for us to be reminded of an ancient time when the gods walked upon the earth and Bhagavati, the mother of all, the feminine divine, appeared for the devas, for humanities, and even for the demons. World order and cosmic orderliness was restored. Then why not become part of this beautiful festival, which reminds us of a very ancient history? All these entangled passions thrive in the atmosphere of moha, delusion, which keeps us in denial of our true motivations. It prevents us from seeing things as they really are and keeps our awareness clouded by a false and finite sense of self. We are not finite. We are not limited. We share the same code as the universal. For aren't we not created in the image and likeness of the Supreme? We share the same code. Therefore, wholeness belongs to us. Happiness belongs to us. It is called Anandam, pure consciousness beyond any ailment, physical or mental. It belongs to us. Ailments belongs to this physicality only. Therefore, Durga's decapitating sword of knowledge allows us to discern between what happens as finite and fleeting and what is infinite and abiding, permanent. In practical terms, it distinguishes between selfish, harmful impulses and the noble selflessness that promotes harmony and points towards unity. This katha, directed at Surat's concern, hints at the theme of good and evil, the theme of good over evil, righteousness overcoming unrighteousness. Shiva, 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 Shambho, Har, 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 Shambho, Shiva, 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 Shambho, Shiva, 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 Shambho, Har, 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 Shambho, Shiva, 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 Shambho, Har, 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 Shambho. Shiva, Shiva, Shambhu, Mahadeva, Shambhu, Shiva, 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 Shambhu, Mahadeva, Shambhu, Shiva, 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 Shambhu, Vishwanath, Shambhu, Shiva, 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 Shambho, Mahadeva Shambho.
शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो शिव शिव शंभो जटाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो जटाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव 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 शंभो गंगाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो जटाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो भोलेनाथ शंभो शिव शिव शंभो हर 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 शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव शंभो गंगाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो गंगाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो गंगाधारी शंभो शिव 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 शंभो महादेव शंभो शिव शंभो महादेव शंभो
the asura chiksur means devoid of clear understanding. The asura chamar means fickle mindedness. The asura uddagra means haughtiness. The asura mahahanu means the great deceiver. The asura asilom, one who is indecisive, want of resolution. Baskalo means poor memory. Parivarita, wandering to and fro. And bidal means hypocrisy, having one like a cat face. Memories, wandering to and fro, devoid of clear understanding. All these thoughts are racing about on horses, lions, and elephants. They are poking at us with their spears and saying, get up, you don't have to sit here. It is not comfortable. You have more important things to do with your life than sitting around a fire, an agni, a yajna, and listening to kathas. What could this do with your life? Why are you wasting your time here? This is not even fun. The whole army of asuras are racing around in all of our minds, continuously poking us with their weapons, telling us to get up. Why would you sit like a yogi? You are not a yogi. Why even try? Why are you reading this foreign language? You don't even understand a word it says. What is the value? What is the necessity? Why are you studying a scripture from 5,000 years? What does it mean to you? Get up and be somebody. Do something with your life. The asuras, the demons, the internal ones, they are continuously poking you with their swords and spears. Everyone is perplexed by these same asuras, the asuras that run the conglomerate world today. The asuras who have taken power and rulership of the world with no spirituality whatsoever. Commerce, commerce, and more commerce. Wealth, 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 division and rule. Divisiveness, these are all the asuras. Is it not an individual phenomena? Everyone is perplexed by the same asuras. These asuras are attacking us. They are not unique to you or personal. They are universal. Earth has been inundated, covered over with the armies of the great ego. Look at how many of us are wandering to and fro. How many of us are afflicted by want of resolution or devoid of clear understanding. Yet still, we can't find time to be reminded of who we are, our spiritual identity. The bodies of the asuras have really covered over the earth, and now she's cutting them all down. Just look at the power of these thoughts. we cut them down and they rise up again. That is Rakta Beach. Rakta Beach, the Asura, the demon. He's killed, his blood touches the ground, and from that drop of blood, another demon duplicate, clone, appears. What happens to that demon within? We cut them down. These are the infinite thoughts that rise up again and again and again and again. There is no calm. There is no fixation. Our minds are in total turmoil and it must be fixated. Some are saying, stop fighting. Stop fighting us. Just do what we dictate. Don't fight us anymore. Surrender. Mahishasura's great ego is the commander-in-chief of the army of thoughts. He sends all of his general who are commanders of their forces. Generals in the army each have special aspects or characteristics. Chiksur, one of the commander, he is devoid of clear understanding. I don't understand that which applies to us. Devoid of clear understanding rains a shower of doubts upon us like that can't be a true teaching. What is this being taught to us? There has got to be something that I don't completely understand. I will take some more teachings rather than practice what I already know. This is one of the problems we suffer. We have our spiritual tools and we have our spiritual toolbox. We continue to accumulate more and more spiritual tools by listening to kathas, the teachings of the scriptures, and what we do, we say as one of the asura, oh, how beautiful, how eloquent it sounds. I will go another night. And then you take your spiritual tools, you take it home, you put it into your spiritual toolbox, and you have never ever acted or practiced upon those principles given to you. The tools given to you, yes, they are eloquent, but they become only effective when they can become part of our lives. Why keep them in your spiritual toolbox? Mahishasura, great ego, here, Parivarita, wandering to and fro, says, don't meditate here. Go over there. This isn't the right place to sit. Let's go someplace else. Wine is better than the divine. Wandering to and fro, Parivarita is a very powerful general in the army of the great ego. The great ego is Mahishasura himself. Want of resolution. Sankalpa means a divine resolution. Asiloma is want for resolution, want for resolve. We make resolutions, we break resolutions. Want of resolution comes and says, this is asiloma, what is that noise behind me? Maybe I should answer that phone now. That is asiloma. It is important, much more than the time given to connect this soul with the universal soul. I must get that telephone call. It is most important. Well, Asi Loma says, the puja can wait. I don't feel comfortable here in the middle of this Chandi part, the scriptural reading. I feel I am in the wrong place. I can go tomorrow. There are many days left. Maybe I will go on the last day. I will show my face. This is Asi Loma speaking to you. We must destroy Asi Loma. Bidal, having a cat face. Hypocrisy is Bidal. Hypocrisy entered the battle with 5,000 million chariots. It is really hard to give up hypocrisy without saying, look what I got for giving it up. Look what I got for making a contribution. I have given so much. I am proud. Without me, it cannot be done. This is Bidal, hypocrisy. Looking for acknowledgement from someone else, expecting some kind of validation or verification. In some way, we want to be validated. Our lives lack, so we want to be validated. I have given. Because of me, the yajna is successful. This is Bidal, cat face, hypocrisy. So hypocrisy really comes to us heavily armed, 5,000 million chariots. Because we want someone to recognize how spiritually evolved we are. As soon as we ask for that validation, hypocrisy bolts out with his millions of chariots racing about. Therefore, especially during these period of high energy levels of the mother, the Navratri, we should watch as she comes into manifestation and allow her, feel her as she takes over your form, our form. And as she takes over our form, as each deva projects their light, the light is being projected into our being, into the core, into our paw, into our limbs, into our faculties. You form that energy and you will become the form of the Divine Mother. Your body is that vessel for her consciousness. This is the Chandi part. As we chant the Nyas, the touching of the fingers, the touching of the limbs, the touching of the heart. We perform Karan Nyas, establishment in the hands. We perform these rituals just as the divine kavacham, the armor or shield of the goddess. We call out to the different energies from the different parts of the bodies where they reside as forms of divinity. And when we chant, we can feel each part of our body like karanyas, the eyes, the fingers, which correspond to the five elements and the five faculties of sense, perception, to see, to touch, to hear, to smell, and to taste. May these senses, their organs and perception be purified, be energized. When we chant, we must feel each part of the body just like we do the touching of the fingertips, see and feel
As her face comes into manifestation, then her neck, then her upper body, then her waist, her thighs, her legs, that manifestation of divine energies is happening to us, through us. It is happening to us and through us. We must feel the goddess taking birth as a pillar of light. She is taking birth in your body, in our bodies, in this form of you, the worshipper. That is the meditation. This is your resolution. This is your sankalpam. This is the celebration of the feminine divine. Boli Sri Adi Shakti Jagadambika Mata Ki Jai. Boli Sri Umapati Mahadeva Ki Jai. Pavan Sut Hanuman Ki Jai. Sab Santan Ki Jai. Sab Bhaktan Ki Jai. Jai Jai Sita Ram. Jai Jai Radhe Shyam. Namah Parvati Pataye Har Har Mahadeva Shambhu. Amaru Dhan Radha Sri Radha Shri Radha. Hamaru Man Radha Shri Radha Shri Radha. Hamaru Tan Radha Shri Radha Shri Radha. Hamaru Dhan Radha Shri Radha. Amaru Dhan Radha Sri Radha Sri Radha. Amaru Man Radha Sri Radha Sri Radha.
Let us celebrate.
तुमेव माता
च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुस् च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देवा ॐ शांति 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 बोले श्री आर शक्ति महामाता की जय उमापति महादेव की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय सब संतन की जय सब भक्तन की जय 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 सीताराम जय जय राधे श्याम नमः पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव शंभू।